I am authorised to close this forest. I have closed the forest and have directed that signs be erected to this effect. You are now required to leave as you are in breach of the forestry of the regulations under the Forestry Act.
Okay. Right, are you leaving now or are you going to be arrested?
Can I
get someone to
Are you leaving now or are you going to be arrested? Hold the back door.
Everywhere, and you can imagine the million and one things living in here, and things they get up to, you know, small little germs to giant things like me.
They let the Aborigines clear the land right, and then they come along and took the land off us. Even one of my great-great-grandfathers in the Kemp area was cleared the rainforest, yeah. Right? And we owned Bellicapini Island, and they took that off us, right? Same as I was in Yellow Rock, where my descendants come from.
Same all the way down Bellingen. All the way down Bellingen too.
Yeah. Yeah. They just let the Aboriginal people clear the land and then come along and just moved us like cattle. You know what I mean? I've got it written in a piece of paper. I'm going to read it about this area.
Yeah.
The Bellingen, Nambaga.
Yeah.
Oh, big boy. So what are they doing? What are they going to do in this area?
Well, just past here, they want a log going down the south facing, like all this stuff, going down the left-hand side of the road, going all the way between here and Mount Killiecrankie. And right around Killiecrankie, all the south and east sides of Killiecrankie as well.
They're going to log this.
Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, we've moved our camp from log dump two in compartment 375 to somewhere else.
Anyway, if we go up here, we find a few surprises. Sounds of hominids.
Can you taste it?
Yeah.
Not many of them left, eh?
Yeah. How come it walk all the way?
That's the red seed. That was the start of the downfall of blackfellas on the Mount
Buckley.
And on the other end of it.
And all the white
come for that tree there. See?
Well, they glory the fact that they took every cedar tree out of this place. There's a plaque in Bowra, right? It's in the middle where the pub is and the real estate, right? That's in there's a plaque.
Read
you read
book.
It and it says, you know, they didn't stop until
there was none left. My cedar cutters came in first, and then the homesteaders and the pastoral came in later, right? The cedar fellas came in, opened up the area, pushed all the my tribal people up in the New England area, you know, it's in the Balboa book. Mm.
They recorded it all because it was just like cattle.
And that bloke in
like
Port Macquarie.
Like we record cattle the, now.
The bloke right? in and Port
we got back into town and found out that a forestry commission grader doing horseshoe had been vandalised. And the headlights were smashed and the instrument panel was smashed. And the hydraulic hoses have been disconnected. The main suspects in this crime were a white combi and a woman with a ring through her lip. So we spun out and went, oh, wow, that's us. thank Christ we were at Bundagen. driving a fucking incredibly noisy car. Steve, why do you want us out? So, between us and the water users group, we've got them from 4,500 cubes down to 600, which isn't, it's 3,900 cubic metres. I mean, that's a fucking lot.
Yeah, we view it as a major victory already, yeah? And as, so now we've just got to work out how to cut them out of the last bit.
They took all that from our grandparents, all the land and things. And after we cleared the land, and then they come in and just pushed us off. But we were making so much money.
They're freehold farmers, Aboriginal freehold farms.
They
just kicked everyone off.
They was, yeah. In the 1812.
I heard right
it's
up
in the, book.
The end of World War II in Bellingen as well.
Yeah.
They were kicking people off their land, giving it to the returned soldiers.
Yeah.
Well, that's how they gave it to them.
Yeah.
Yeah, you had to be a soldier.
No, off somebody else. Missed out.
Well, we had a fellow with Second World War. He was Eddie Donahue. He came back and he was my uncle. And he came back and he was a wreck. They didn't give him any land or anything. Well, that big piece of land they're living on in the reserve they live in at Bellwood, right? If we wouldn't have went in and took it to the High Court, that would have reverted back to Crown land. Because nobody owns.
Still under land claim as well.
Oh, yeah, it's still under land claim. Yeah, we don't have to worry. That will be, I guess, by Saturday morning, tomorrow night, Saturday morning, we'll know what legislation we can pull on then. yeah.
That's good because they want to start on Monday. Logging the wonder.
Yeah, I fuck it.
That's my sentiment exactly.
No. They live there. It's their permanent place of residence. You, in all our correspondence, have said that you're not into conflict. You're going to get a conflict if you tell them to go. Well, you're going to get a jack-up from them, Steve. We've satisfied all the requirements under your legislation that says we need 200 litres of water. We've got a dam there. I think the only way that you're going to get us out of there is by taking one of them to court. And I'd like to see you try that one, Steve. That's the only way that you're going to get us out of the forest. You close it, we'll disappear further into the forest. You won't see us, but we'll still be there.
You can squat on crown land for 8 years and you own it.
I think Brady and the women need to cut a finger off.
Yeah, that's lovely up here.
Fresh air, you're breathing in fresh air, bud. You live longer.
All they say is the white side light in town. You know, you come out here, what you feel, nothing. There's church, no one watching you, no one looking and telling you what to do.
Yeah. No law, no what's it, mate. No English system.
That's it.
Biden telling you what to do.
Yeah, we're claiming.
The Indonesian women, they file their teeth.
That'll be here for the next generation. For generations after that.
For everyone, see?
Look, I just tell them, look, you're coming this way, half of the New England range, right? You get the other half, it's all desert, right?
It's all desert, yeah.
It's only a strip from Mount Warning, Mount Tambourine, to Mount Warning up here, is only a strip far as Gloucester. There's no more.
They're down the south coast.
It's gone.
They don't have anything else. It's gone. That's what they went to do at the back here.
Plus they're coming inland, they're gathering more wassup. They're clearing more land and wassup. There's only a strip, but that's nothing left.
But they don't understand, see?
Well,
they don't wanna.
If we didn't have this, we wouldn't breathe.
I was wondering if it was made out of hemp.
You know, that's why they stopped the hammers and was it over there, mate?
They would have all been made by
trees. Climb trees, they don't go on the ground.
That's right. They said they were going to move them, but they don't. They'll circle a dead tree until they die. They won't
that's
move.
Right.
You can't move them.
I won't move.
They're generations of families in the same tree.
Well, they did the same thing to Aboriginal people, you know.
Yep.
They moved them from one tribal area to another. And mixed tribes.
No,
which was never happened in traditional times, you know. So it's, they do the same thing for the animals.
Yeah, you see him breathing there? Mm-hmm. Down on this side, better, Jeff?
Yeah.
Alright, look at him, man.
He's having a good rest. Got a nice spot anyway.
When I was up at my daughter, she lived at Cuyahoga right on the mountains.
Yeah.
I was listening one morning, and one was over there singing out the first part, and the other part over this side.
Oh, yeah.
So there's two birds singing out. Think it's one, but it's not.
What sort of bird was it?
The whip bird.
Wow.
See, that first part is, and the second part is another bird. A male and female.
The male and the female, yeah, right.
Yeah.
Still be there. You won't see us because we're forest dwellers. And we know that forest like the back of our hand. That's going to be the consequence if you close the forest. You've got to come and drag one of us into court, kicking and screaming, and find out what happens. You're not going to get any money out of us. And the person that goes to court's just going to go boing back to the forest because that's where they live.
This is good quality because I'm...
This is how you put a hard hat on from the greenies in the forest. Bit of a step up from Steve Mason's plastic hat. And this has got nature written all over it, not just a name.
Let's have a look at the inside.
Yeah, right.
That's
a big vine. Wow, look at that.
Get a camera, get a camera.
Bring your hand back.
Oh. Yeah, put that aside. Put that aside.
Maidenhair tree.
Way up here, look. We need to
hear you. They call it the maidenhair tree.
Could you see him?
It makes that medicine for people with bad hearts.
You go right up at the top there, see? And you get, when you get up the top, you see all over the canopy.
I'm there.
Up inside.
No, it's not difficult for me to accept. It's difficult for me to pass on to the others.
Getting us out of the agreement, threatening to pull out of the agreement. Field bus mob went over the back over to the compartment and found a whole lot of yellow belly V notches in the trees. I wrote to forestry and said that we were so totally unhappy with the agreement. And now we have yellow belly scratch marks. We demanded that they stay out of the compartment until a full and comprehensive survey had been done.
The real question is that forest a high conservation forest that satisfies 7 out of 10 of the NEPA criteria? If it does, then... Well, if it does, then you forget the rest, and it's a NEPA block A. That's what John Corkle said to me on the phone a few days ago. Okay, now we've got to decide what we want to do with that, whether we want to actually do that.
Lots of butterflies you don't see. Even the birds you don't. A lot of birds you don't see. A lot of them anymore. Honeyeaters, it's a special sort of honeyeater. I used to see them when I was a kid. Burrow in the side of a ground, make a hollow in the ground. I used to live in the side of a sort of a cliff, and it was all pretty coloured with a long beak. But I haven't seen any of them for a long time. They don't understand, do they?
A lot of things that you can weather. That's good to give to your dog, right? Your friends?
The bracken.
The bracken? The bracken. Your dog will tick. Just mash it up for him and water, a little bit of water.
Right.
Put a little cure the tick.
If you can find one for skin cancer, do you know which one's for skin cancer?
Yeah, up here. That's the thorn apple. It's like a spiky tomato-y looking thing with thorns all over it. It comes out with this yellow-orange berry. And you cut the berry in half when it goes yellow and just rub it on. It doesn't burn like milkweed, not the same way.
Yeah,
I've used it myself, it fades it away.
It can be a bit wrong.
They made a cream out of that. They had it for sale for 6 months in Queensland about 10 years ago and the government banned it. No joke.
Solved too many problems.
It's called Curoderm.
Curoderm?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you could use it locally. If you hear someone just gotta go and try it on them, you know?
Yeah.
Get out of the bloody forest! I'm sorry you don't understand, but get out of the bloody forest. Occupational Health and Safety Act, Bushfires Act.
So when does he want people out?
Friday. Today week. Yes. Which is already a week over the period that... when the bushfire danger period starts anyway. So you're getting a fortnight. You've been on notice for a long time that you have to get out of that forest. I told those people in the log dump months ago.
So, I wonder when they want to start now. They've put it back a few days because they have to alter the harvest plan significantly. So they want
to
start
Monday
week.
Significantly again, too.
Why so?
Well, I'm going to write a letter to Parks and Wildlife today. We've got possible logging starting on Monday.
No, and we've still got yellow-bellied gliders and koalas in the compartment they won't admit are there.
And
let alone palmer wallabies.
Palmer wallabies and bettongs and God knows what else. All this logging encourages new growth and these little beasties,
they like the new growth
and that. And things. Yeah, it's a crock of shit. Yeah, I better get into town.
This here?
Memorial.
Yeah, what's the memorial about?
Three young kids that were missing from here in late 1990. Some were caught for, but he ended up getting off it.
Yeah, really?
Mm.
And so what, they disappeared?
Yeah. They just went missing one night at parties. The youngest one just went walking about one morning and never come back.
And so the memorial park here has been put up since then?
Yes, they've done it in dedication to the three people, to the three young kids.
What happened? Okay, we drove up to Mackay's Road. We decided, do we go down Mackay's Road or down the easy road? We decided to go down the hard road. Cruising down, five of us in the back at the time, and suddenly we stopped. There in front of us was a giant machine, like a semi-trailer with oversized
driven
across it.
Huge motherfucker truck.
Yeah, big truck.
Yep.
And Jarrah leans out the driver's window and says, "Hey, what's going on here?" And they say, "Oh, well, we're going to log today."
He said, "For legal reasons, do not log."
Yes, and he says, "Don't do a thing for legal reasons, do not. And then he turns the car around and he's going, "Oh, fucking yellow fucking glider, fucking rah, 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 rah. You can delete that if you like. And
No, don't, and then
we charge back to camp. And Jarrah takes off in the car and races into camp and says, "There's a bulldozer in the compartment." And everybody goes, "Yeah!" People are screaming all over the place.
Before they left.
And everybody grabbed the drums, and then we raced off and grabbed a bit more gear, like ropes and stuff, and threw it all in the car. And
yeah.
Ran, oh, great. She climbed up the dozer. Yeah,
we're great. We're asking the guys all these amazing questions like, you married, you got kids, and...
Yeah. Got a heart? That's what Esperanza was saying. Have you got a heart? Have you got a conscience? Can you feel anything? Esperanza, wasn't that beautiful, that conversation, that heart conversation you had with them, about half an hour of it or something? We've got to go get reinforcements, then we're going to go back and see if they've decided to come back tomorrow or not. If they've decided to come back tomorrow, then we'll just whack up tripods and stuff.
I wish I could be here tomorrow.
We've decided to blockade Little Wonder tonight with tripods and whatever else we can whack up there until a comprehensive independent survey has been done of the compartment, because this morning we found no more than 10 metres in front of the most recent bulldozer track a bunch of koala scats right on the track, 10 metres in front of where they were going to push the road to. They found no yellow belly feed notches up there, although we've heard them for months and months and months going off in the compartment. They agree that independent checks should be done, but they don't like our independence. Our independent survey is apparently crap to them. So we're just going to blockade until we can get some kind of agreement from them.
And what, they just turned up with the dozers in there today?
Yeah, we accidentally turned down Mackay's Road instead of going down Horseshoe and found the dozer sitting in the compartment with forestries and loggers surrounding it. We haven't finished our yellow belly survey. We haven't finished the rainforest typing discrepancy check. We haven't done the check of the marking foreman's work. They haven't done an archaeological survey to the Gumbungi's satisfaction. So we figure that any agreement that we've previously signed is out the window until they can satisfy us that there are no yellow bellies in that compartment, and they're not going to do that because we've heard them. Until that happens, we're going to not allow them to work.
Oh, well, I guess I'll see you up there.
Yeah.
About 800 metres up there.
Mm.
most endangered ones. Oh.
Like see, it is a fortune here, if you want to destroy things.
Yeah, right? That's it.
Do you want to be a destroyer?
But I think it's gone to a point now where the earth won't sustain it any longer at the pace that they take.
Well, they come in this way. Look. They're moving this way off to New England. Yeah. Land are clearing. This way. There's only a little stretch from the Newcastle area, and they're not even near the Newcastle area anymore. Mm. Just down the Gloucester area, up to Mount Warning. That's all that's left.
And every other state in Australia, it's all gone.
Yeah.
We're the last, this is it.
Daintree is nothing, but they're building within Daintree.
Yeah, and you can't.
Right, there's roads through it and everything.
There needs to be so much of it to sustain life. Yeah, you can't just have a little patch. You need a big area, it has to be huge to sustain that whole system of life.
But you're talking about a strip, only a strip from Mount Warning up in the Queensland border there down to Gloucester. That's the only bit of land.
Yeah, nothing on the escarpment, nothing on the coast, just a tiny strip through the foothills all the way down.
But once you get to Nunnell into Gloucester, well, it's thus cleared or logged out.
It's called Leet.
It's only a strip.
Is it?
But once it goes, it goes.
That's right.
And we go with it.
Isn't that why they've got a problem up at Dogo? Because they've logged it all? They've got like a problem with the salinity or something?
There's a problem with everything up there.
Yeah,
they've got no industry, no nothing.
We looked after the land. We didn't kill it.
Oh, no, that.
And I went out west and I was surprised that there's no more water rats in the river. In the 60s, when I was out in the western region, my mate used to shoot the water rats for the pelts, right? And the pelts were like mink, right? And now I went out in the last 3 years, I looked in the water, all the waterways, and there's nothing there. No rats. It's wiped out. It's of man's destruction.
Mm-hmm.
The non-Aboriginal, the Europeans migrated to the country, they destroyed it.
You wonder why the ice is all melting.
So how long you been up here then? The sort of logging team been up and stuff?
No idea, mate.
Oh, no worries.
First night up here.
Oh, I see. Shut up. So, like the security guys are down there, all the equipment's in the compartment. Yeah, we can't blockade from the top.
We're not going to be moving them out of there.
We can't set tripods up or lock onto the equipment.
So they're already in there. So what's the use? They got the diesel there. They can stay there for as long as they want.
That's right.
They can doze is just there now.
The only thing we can do is to set up tripods in front of them on the sneak track.
Well, when the camp moved, well. They moved straight in, didn't they? Soon as Steve fucking seen we was out of there, he most probably just give them the order to kill and went straight in, they did.
Yeah.
They're there and we not moved them now.
Oh, well, let's hope everybody gets back tonight after their meeting then.
Yeah, well.
We need a lot of people, you know. Oh.
A bit more support right there, eh?
Yeah.
We'd try out and get all these contractors and that and see what they got to say tomorrow. All these loggers, the poor bastards who just cut the timber. They're the fellas we're going to have a yarn to, tell them to go to hell. You're doing illegal acts on Aboriginal land, or soon to be, hopefully.
That's
since
right.
The claim is already in. Yeah. They can't say that it isn't.
That's right.
And they're supposed to stop everything until that fucking tribunal decides on who owns what and where and when.
Yeah,
it's supposed to be law, that's the law, ain't it? Back in the system, that's how it's supposed to work.
That's how it's supposed to work. You're equal owners with forestry until the tribunal decides.
Everyone's out trying to save koalas and that, and these bastards are up here fucking dozering away their habitat trees.
All this stuff.
And nothing left of the yellow-bellied gliders, look, they're just surviving here.
Yeah. Right underneath.
Yep.
The noses of everyone who's been looking for.
Pushing the dozer straight through their fucking heartland now. The only places left they do survive. You can't go any further west. What's out there?
Fucking bear paddocks.
Bear paddocks and sheep and fucking shit like that. Rabbits everywhere.
Dead trees.
And boulders.
Dead tree forests.
Yep. Fucking sticks. can't push them any further. Got to stop somewhere. So it might as well be here.
The dozers are in there, and there's fucking two security guards there with guns. So it's not exactly appropriate to blockade, to put tripods over the bloody machines. This is a real shame because they're right close to each other. We probably could have gotten both with one pod. Right. Hey.
Yeah.
And the diesel tank.
What we're going to do is wake up in the morning to occupied tripods and this is the plan.
Plus we've got plenty of gear as well. Plenty of gear to lock on with.
You get the tall people. Tall people on the vehicle.
It's just the vehicle.
Plane. Lights out.
Now this one's underneath, this is a push pole. There's the underneath and the over the top fucking school, and we're going for the underneath school tonight.
Yeah. Don't forget to keep your eye on the apex.
Okay. How are we going?
Good, happy? Good, good. Yeah,
okay,
push.
Put it up.
1, 2, 3, push. 1, 2, 3, push. 1, 2, 3, push. So I've got one lock on so far.
One and a half.
And do we have two? We need at least one person to support these two women.
People that lock on will probably be able to escape.
I'd like Luda.
They'll be able to get away.
Yeah, this is a tripod. Look. This is a full-on traffic block job. And I'm stoked because I haven't had to do it for years. I can stop the traffic.
Woo-hoo. So what do you reckon, the two tripods will stop four-wheel drives as well?
These two will, once we've got the extra pole across.
Who's not got a job up here now? Hands up high so I can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We got ourselves a tripod crew. And
six,
I guess
nine.
You get the coffee first.
Have you got a volunteer to go up, mate?
Yeah, out of that group, who wants to go up?
It's quite possible you won't be arrested, guys, so
the main action's likely to be up here.
So it's gonna be a pretty easy.
And the cops can't be in two places at once.
I love it. Occupy tripod. Someone might Little Wonder Free State, man.
I think it was 20 metres here as well, around the rainforest and 100 metres from the creek,
And then they gave the river users group 350 metres from the creek, but that was because it was all over 30 degrees.
Right. Over 30?
Yeah.
Well, it's recommended not over 35. It's not recommended not over 25, but they can go up to 30.
Yeah.
Or more.
It probably worked out that 25 would cut out too much and made a middle way mark.
This would be the first way they'd come in for sure. But do you reckon they don't even know?
They think this is all this. They don't know that those and stuff like that's been locked on and they don't know. They don't call it in shock. They don't know the other one's rocked it. Well, they think this is it.
And they don't know about the bottom of the road or anything.
They don't know. They're walking in this one.
The security guards up in the compartment, they got radios?
Yeah, they got a mobile. They came down, both of them came down while our crew was going back up and they've apparently captured them.
Well, I better go up there then.
Probably.
Hi there.
How are you, mate?
Well, thanks. Hope you don't mind me filming in the daytime.
Nah, mate. About the night time, innit?
You've got a shot.
Yeah, then we've got the back of the buddy. Great, wouldn't you, last night?
Yeah, that's about it. So what's happened to you, then?
Don't know how this poor girl managed to get a chain wrapped around her neck and just attached this day. So that's amazing.
It's amazing how things happen, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, not to matter.
How's that? It's about jewelry display.
Hey, like you, and the others weren't here, and they were just the two people were here, and I just walked up and talked to them, and then this young brother turned up, and I had a rave to them, and then they ended up saying, oh, we're blocked in, and you know, we'll go and check it out, and they all just got up and got in the car, and I said, oh, are you all leaving me here? And they just said, yes, we'll give you $10 an hour for minding the bulldozers, and I said, oh, okay, see you later. And they got in the car and left. And Ingrid and Amanda came running on the scene. And that was it. It was really, they left and left them to us.
All of this?
All of
to
this.
You.
And said I could mine them and they'd pay me for it.
Oh, you didn't do
the
job.
I didn't do the job very well for them though.
Oh, you could put it down at the CES though.
I could, couldn't I?
They offered me a job.
But I failed the test.
I'll let the greens lock on.
So, are they good places? Do you lock them on in good places?
How you feeling?
Good, yeah. Quite
well, these ones good ones, eh? Like, we're just trying to get the best comfortable ones, eh? Killer place, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look,
it's
a great place. It's quite cozy.
How do they get the cryptos off?
Some sort of cutters, I guess.
Forestry coaches arrived, and all of the forestry vehicles are up the top road, so the people down the bottom are probably coming back any minute.
Okay, excellent. And they can't get through the tripods at all?
No, but there's not enough people down there, so I've got to get back there in just a minute.
Yeah, cool.
Comfortable?
Yeah, really comfortable. Yeah, good sleep here.
So you guys do this, are you professional greenies?
No,
or?
I live down the hill actually, I just did a video.
Right.
A couple of the others here, oh, they travel around a bit, but most of the people here, they've actually been in the forest for about a year,
yeah.
Camped up around here. Mm. So not so much professional greenies, as I guess professional squatters right now.
Yeah, that's smart.
But a bit of both, yeah.
Well, it's about time if I can, that's why people start getting a bit of land back.
They've gone down to dismantle the dozer.
Oh dear, is something wrong with it?
Yeah. Morning, how's it going?
Ah, good, good.
Um,
well, try going the other way, it won't get in. Now I've got a tripod like that, look, there's a gate there, right? A tripod like that, and another one like that, over the same gate. There's only five of them down there, but the springs are right onto it.
I'm trying to talk code, man. Are you okay?
Hey, okay, fine.
Great.
I'm happy. And
Roger, Roger.
Roger, Dodger, man.
Yeah. Came down here and left the bulldozers unguarded.
So if the security guards came down here?
Yeah, that's what I was just told. This morning to have a bit of a look. I was so amazed at all this. A couple of people went up and bumped off.
You're joking!
You told them that ultimatum.
No, we haven't. No, we haven't.
It leaves it more open and they're going to be less sure of what they should do. It makes it just a little bit more dynamic. Make it clear, be the ones in charge, this is what we're doing, this is our limit.
Let's tell Steve that when he gets here. Let's get him up here.
What if he just gives instructions over the radio? There's 11 people there and two security guards waiting for instructions from Steve Racing. And he's deciding what instruction to give without knowing what your ultimatum is.
I'll talk to you as a group.
Okay.
Okay. Situation is, right, I've spoken to my superiors at Port Macquarie and at Maxwell. At this stage, the harvest plan is a legal document which gives the loggers the right to go in and start their operations. At this stage, the Forest Commission are prepared to let you stay in the area and negotiate, but if there's any obstruction to their operations, the forest will be closed and you'll be asked to leave the area.
Yeah.
Okay, now you're prepared to let the blokes go in to start their operations?
We're prepared to let these guys go in and start work once we've been satisfied that State Forests have done what they said they were going to do.
At this stage, the options that are open to you, if you feel that the harvest plan is not correct or whatever, is that I've been advised that you should take out legal proceedings again and take out an injunction or whatever. But at this stage, you're hampering a lawful operation. And
it's not lawful until we've seen a final harvesting plan
that's
that we're
enough.
Happy with.
Right, but
that was the agreement that we reached.
Right, okay. Now, I'm officially directing you to move the roadblock. If you fail to remove the roadblock and let the police, let the loggers commence their operations, you will be either arrested or legal action will be taken against you. Do you understand that?
Me personally?
Well, everybody that...
We have a half an hour to talk about it as a group.
Righto. But that's all I can give you. Righto. I've got to be fair to both sides.
Yeah.
At this stage, the Forestry Commission, like I said, are prepared to let you stay in your camp down there if you don't hamper their operations. But
We agreed.
Mate, that's what it is. I'm not...
No. Just let me finish. We agreed. We, the forest dwellers, agreed to not hinder logging operations. We signed the agreement. On the condition that State Forests do several things. We're not happy with those several things. We don't believe that they've been done to our satisfaction. And until they are done to our satisfaction, we will hinder logging operations.
Well, that's what I've been directed, or I've been authorised, or I've been instructed to do. That's
Would you like to communicate what I've just... told you to your superiors?
Before you do that, let's have half an hour and work out our message.
Because these blokes are ready to start work. They're at this stage, they're lawfully entitled to start work. The harvest plan has been approved.
Yep.
Okay, if you've got any objections to it, there's ways and means that you can do it lawfully. Okay, but at the moment, this is an unlawful roadblock and you are committing an offence. Okay?
Right. I understand that, but honestly, they have been trying to do everything lawfully. I really have.
I know. That's fair enough, but that's just the way it is, okay?
Okay.
Rightio?
Yep.
An illegal roadblock.
Is this illegal? You're stuck up here doing an illegal activity.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
You can pull out now if you want. And take legal
you
means.
Tell me beforehand.
Look, I'm going to sue somebody.
Sue!
Who do I sue?
Do you think they've been down to the other place and told them the same thing?
No, I don't know
that they're there, and we really need them.
I think we get on the blower right now, get the radio up. That's the priority. Get the radio up and firing, and get as many of them down there up here as possible. Tell them the cops are in, and they won't close us down. And that, you know, basically they're already up here. They're not going to be here at all. They can basically abandon that pod to two people, virtually.
Yeah, just man it.
Well, I think they'll wait and get a fucking cherry picker up here. Probably one on its bloody way.
George is right though, they've got a pile of people here, they could do it any one of a number of ways. We better get a pile of people here fast, one way or the other.
Is that radio down the
phone? We've only got half an hour, they're going to come back for an answer. Are you going to say that we're staying?
We'd
basically want to avoid confrontation as well. We'd really like to be working this out. Well,
and everybody can appreciate your views, and we're not here to take sides. We don't want a confrontation, but the loggers, as you can appreciate, it's cost them a lot of money to set up and all that sort of thing too, and they've got sort of rights as well. But like I said, the forestry, they're prepared to negotiate and let you stay in the forest as long as the operations aren't hampered. But if they are hampered, well then, action's going to have to be taken.
I understand, but you've got to understand too that the situation with forestry is we actually have got an agreement on with forestry, and part of the agreement is that before they come in and log, that we're allowed to inspect the tree markings, we're allowed to inspect. This is all in black and white with forestry. That's what we don't understand.
Again,
they haven't met their legal obligations under a legally binding document, and that's why we're here. So it's the same from both sides, you see.
Fair enough.
You're in the middle, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I know. I'm in the middle. I can appreciate that, but that's just what the go is at this stage. Right, from the police point of view, the harvest plan is a lawful document, and if you want to take action against it, you should do it through the courts. That's our advice, and what you do from here on is up to you. Okay.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
If we decide to stay here until we can negotiate with Steve Rayson, will you be bringing in police from Nambucca?
Police are coming. Right.
They're already called. How many police are coming?
I don't know. But there are other police coming, but at this stage, it's not for a confrontation, it's for negotiations.
Right.
So that's why,
we really want to avoid this as well, but that's sort of our priority. We want to avoid this confrontation. But we do also, there's people here who feel really strongly that they have actually had their agreement breached and might not be so easy to move. So what we want is more time to maybe try and work out a middle ground with Steve before anything does happen. And that might take us more than half an hour. It would be good to actually be speaking to him maybe on a mobile phone.
That's a matter for the Forestry Commission. I'll see if I can find out if he is coming.
Yeah. Send his way to come out and we could do what the harvesting plan said.
We kind of did that yesterday. Like, we checked out trees that we thought had fee notches on them, and we weren't satisfied with Forestry's result. They said no to everyone and said they were grubs. I mean, maybe they were, but we don't know that for sure. We want someone independent to come in and have a look around, because we know,
that's what the problem is. They've gone for the walk yesterday, and as far as from they're concerned, there's no problems. They've contacted National Parks and Wildlife. At this stage, they've done everything that they feel that they're duty-bound to. So
it's basically a lack of communication at this stage, and we've got to communicate with them to work it out before this can be solved. So we'd like time to do that.
Well, at this stage, that's all I've been asked to convey to you.
is that, you know, like, if you're going to have a talk, try to do it. Like, I don't think you're going to have all day to be able to try to talk it out. I'll go see if Steve Grayson can come.
We get the on the phone or
they said that they'd be coming up in a couple of days. They also said that they'd do the rainforest typing discrepancies business. They also said that they'd do the check of the marking foreman's work. But they're in here starting to cut before we've had a chance to do it.
I can't comment on their policy.
Well, yeah, I'm just communicating to you why we've got this here.
Yeah.
We'd like to be able to come to a final harvesting plan. I mean, God, they're down to 600 cubic metres. These guys are small sawmillers. We're not against them. They're taking all the timber to their mill. It's not going to boil, so there's no jack-up about wood chips, as far as we know. Had it been 4,000, we would have been here because of the wood chips, and we wouldn't have let anybody through until they, you know, sacked boil or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Mate, yeah, that's what something you've got to negotiate out, fair enough, and all I can convey to you is that's the situation at this stage.
No worries.
Always
want
to see a
tripod. You never see one like this.
And there's cops on the way. Which means that there'll be a cherry picker on the way as well.
Oh shit, you know? Fuck this! Fucking knew the bulldozer started up. It was going.
Well, he started the engine.
Yeah, I thought he was about to take off. And then, Zach ran in front and he shoved Zach off. And he's out for the person who's got the keys. Like, they're fucking dead meat. And I'm just going, fuck, you know? Like, he's fully going up, hey. And we're going, oh, cool. and we said, okay.
It's
like, we're trying to work out, okay, what are we going to do, you know? The guys on the border, they're probably safe now, but now they're up to the fuck with the keys. So we thought, okay, what we'll do, we'll come back and we'll say that the key was passed to someone, which was then passed to someone, and none of us know where it is.
Yeah.
And I've come to track down to find it. We've also heard the police aren't coming up.
Yeah, they're over
here. They've already been here.
And they're gone.
No, they're still here.
We've been discussing what we should do. Fuck. Oh, they were telling us the police weren't coming, and that was it. See you later.
Lots of police on the way, though.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool then. I'll go and tell them it's back on then.
Yeah.
Oh, cool, okay.
If you feel unsafe, then don't. The security guards are cool, like they're about to pull up their guns on the, what's his name, the Joseph. The security guards down here, they're real rednecks, like they're full on rednecks, like they were just like, we're gonna come to life, and it's like, it was full on, mate, like he was going, I don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck, we're going, she's gonna die, you know, he's going, I don't give a fuck, you know.
Saying that this morning when we got pole.
Yeah, but he had it started and he was starting to move it a bit around,
and Eddie Griffith underneath it. Yeah. And the security guards pulled
their
guns
on him.
Yeah, he was just lifting up the blade and putting it down, and, you know. No. You're going, we know where your fucking camp is, we can come in and bash you up any time we want to, and, like, they're going to be up for Zach's blood, they've got him on target.
Come on, Zach, get out of there, man.
Yeah.
He was just hanging with you because you guys apparently said you weren't going to touch it.
Well, that's bullshit, you know.
That's what he said.
You touched it. You touched my machine.
Touched.
That's right.
As opposed to wreck.
I said.
Yeah, well, that's what Glenn was going off at him, you know. You know, that's the point, you know. Like, we're not wrecking your machines. We're touching them. We're not wrecking them. And they just went off about half an hour on that tangent, you know.
Has anybody got any dressings for wounds?
Yeah, I need some too. One of the girls was locked on and he just got thrown into his bulldozer and started up, and it was only that someone else ran out in front of him and jumped in front of him, and he ended up assaulting that person and throwing him aside. That and everyone else, including the security officers, were saying, look, stop, you're going to kill her. And he was like, I don't give a fuck. She can go. And he was full on, like he was going to do it. What else happened then? Yeah, like it's, he was, you know, and he's put death threats on everyone after the came. He's saying he's going to go in there and bash the fuck out of everyone and kill them all. He doesn't care.
Okay. I'll speak to him. But what the offer is at this stage, I'll just go for once again.
Is everybody listening? Yes.
Right. Where it's conceded that there could be, or they're going to make further checks up where the log dump is, you know, like about, and check there and go through that with Stu Grayson and negotiate, go for a walk through all that top end area where they went through yesterday with Christina, check on the yellow belly and the koala trees, right?
Okay.
And there's no dispute about that. They'll go through with you. They're prepared to go through with you and you know, do a survey through that, right? But what they want to do this morning is get work started on the log dump, which is down over the side where there is no colonies.
Where the fall trees is down over the side where they were late yesterday afternoon.
Right.
Okay, so you're agreeing not to log the area where it was said that we believe there are yellow-bellied gliders.
That's
from, is that right?
That's from
the ramp site in that area where they pulled those two logs up there yesterday where the tractor is and the grader is.
Now.
Use that ramp site.
What about the old snig track?
I don't believe it.
What about the old snig track? Do you want to push that old snig track through today?
No, I don't know which...
The snig track just passed log dump too.
I don't know.
You know where they went down yesterday?
Yeah. I don't know.
That's a snigging track they want to use.
Well, there's a problem there. We've just found 60 koala scats in front of the bulldozer. Is it?
Yeah.
So, Rena, I don't know where everything is in there. Are they actually, does it sound to you like they're going to avoid the area where there's yellow bellies?
I just want to have someone independent, you know, some mediator in between that can, you know, may have more open eyes, may see, you know, if they have a love for fauna, may see what they want to see, rather than dollar signs on trees.
Because what we have
to
decide...
You know where we went yesterday? Is that in dispute? Yeah, like, no, sorry, where we went yesterday afternoon, you know where the dozer started off and went down, they pulled the two logs
well,
up? Is that in dispute there?
There's a dispute about the whole compartment because, I mean, we found those scats, you know, 20 metres, and they're on a track, and they hadn't been spotted by any forestry people, so that just says that they haven't done proper surveys on the whole compartment, you know?
And he's more or less conveyed, well, if you're not prepared to negotiate and make a concession there, well, there's no more deals.
Mm. Well, both for Jarrah and
yeah.
Well, if we have some time to think about it, and Jarrah's gone down to ring Steve Grayson now, right, and speak to him about it, so we need time to confer and, you know.
That's the offer he asked me, mate. Fair enough, right?
Yeah. Okay, we'll get to you.
Thanks very much. But the girls up there are a bit worried as well.
Police up there because it's quite scary for the people up there.
Well, there's only one of me at this stage.
Yeah. Can no one else down there go up there because that's what's scaring them. Because those people are scary and they're really threatening people like death threats.
Well, wouldn't it be better, like, I can't be here and back down there, like, stretch it at this stage. Wouldn't it be better, like, the tripods are here, right? I'm not going to sneak in and attack at this stage or do anything, you know, silly, righto. There's only one of me, righto. Just bring the girls back down here and you stay together here as a group.
We can't
unlock them. That's the serious fact.
And that's what we were trying to tell him when he just kept on trying to start the engine.
Right, well, it's his dozer, yeah, and...
Yeah, but they don't have a key, and there's a person's life at risk, actually. Very close friend.
I understand, I wasn't there, I haven't been past this point, but all I will say, as I understand it, they went up, the man that went with them was a serviceman, they fitted a new oil gauge, they had to test the oil pressure in the new oil gauge, it was only an oil gauge, they started the engine and lifted the blade, and, wait there, just hold it, I'm only saying what Quinn Young told me, he started the engine, he lifted the blade, his blade's lifted with oil pressure, he's lifted the blade, he had to rev the motor, and that's what he did. Now, I wasn't there.
What was he doing up when there was somebody underneath the dozer?
Mate.
It's his dozer.
Couldn't he have waited later?
Well, it's cost him a fortune to bring up a...
There's a person under there. Money is completely out of the question. There's a person underneath that dozer.
Right. It's his dozer. They've paid big money to get a service maintenance motor. I heard, but you're not listening either. Yeah. Well, I'm not going to get into arguments, right? But you can't have it all one way.
No.
Okay? So,
both ways.
Yeah, it's got to go both ways. I'm not gonna. I don't want to get into any arguments or discussions.
What did they reckon on the radio? Yeah, though?
I just
do that.
She didn't know of anybody specifically that was on their way up, but she was gonna do the ring around and find out if anybody could come up. I'll go and talk to her again in 10-15 minutes.
Okay.
Maybe I should have brought my card.
Great to see you.
Yeah, it's good to see you.
Some people from downstream.
Hello. Hi. Hi, Will.
Hello.
Yeah, sure, sure. It's all part of the bigger picture. If there's no trees, there's no animals. If there's no trees, there's no water. It's all part.
Do you agree at all to any native logging?
No. Of course, no, no.
Maybe you shouldn't have anything to do with negotiations because they're going to. I mean, it's a regrowth session and they are under the harvesting plan. I would love it. You've already got an incredible harvesting plan, Jay. I don't know what the fuck you people are complaining about. Just give them the fauna sites and go fucking home.
Yeah, let's stop upsetting
Don't come at me like that, man.
You started accusing people.
I'm not fucking accusing anybody. Look, last time.
Stop yelling! Stop fucking yelling.
Don't make any agreements with them. That's all I'm saying.
I won't even talk.
Please.
Did anyone in Buckland make an effort to find out?
Nobody in Buckland was told! Nobody! We knew nothing about it!
Did you know that it was on the harvest plan?
I'm just going to go tell them
this.
We were just putting
them on hold. Will that work?
I've written a letter to them. I've had no reply to that letter. In the letter it says that we believe that their marking foreman is incompetent as a wildlife surveyor. We want the Kempsey Warhope prescriptions and we want Parks and Wildlife and Forestry to come up here and do a survey.
Where is the dozers and stuff now?
There's two girls chained to them.
They will throw us out of here. They will pull these down. They're bringing police up from Kempsey. They'll arrest us all, man. And then we stand to lose everything, right? We stand to lose all that we've got, right?
Well, no, that's not true. That's the bluff. You don't stand to lose anything. The harvest plan is a legal document.
It might be a bluff, Ram, but it's also a risk that we're facing, right? People are going to get arrested, man. Everyone's been here for 28 hours. We're all fucking buggered.
Yeah.
I don't think personally that there's a great many people that are.
I apologise. They want an answer now, do they? Is that the story?
They're getting itchy feet.
Well, they came up here this morning, right, with the police, and they gave us half an hour to come up with a decision, right?
Yeah.
Pending that the cops would come in, take this down, arrest us, and close the forest.
But that was a couple of hours ago now.
And they had it turned up.
There was one police that was sitting out there on the road.
That's the only policeman we've spoken with all day, mate.
He fucking pulled over.
He said there's more police coming from Port Macquarie.
Right.
That's what he said, but they haven't turned up.
I mean, they'll tell you anything, though. I mean, you just got to.
Oh, of course. So.
Well, if they can talk you out, that's the best way to do it. I'd do the same in that situation.
So, I don't
why
know
wouldn't you?
I mean, they're going to have a hard time shutting this forest off. It's got that many ways into it.
How far from here is it to the grade? Is it?
You know where the camp was?
Oh, I know where the camp was. But
one K.
I don't know from here to there.
One and a half K's tops, 1K from there.
Parks and Wildlife issued the Forestry Commission with a licence to take and kill endangered species.
And also to pollute water.
Yeah. Who does the taking and killing and polluting?
The contractor.
Yep, bingo. There's a court case waiting to happen. Have them into court under section 98 and 99 of the Parks and Wildlife Act for taking and
but
killing.
But that's just subcontracting
species.
Out. That you know.
No,
doesn't
it's a contract. It's not a subcontract. I've just been through a court case, which the judge almost proved that we were acting lawfully by being up there and locked on. Because the other guy wasn't, because he didn't have a license. Now that court case is still pending.
There's an important piece of news here that affects everyone slightly.
I've just been talking, the forest is now closed. Okay, the police being just compartmentalised.
Does that mean anyone else coming in can't come in?
They've gone to the front of the road to try to stop people. They cannot stop them forcibly. If they want to go through, they will go through, and they cannot stop them forcibly. The people that will go up there and they'll say, well, the forest is closed. They may turn around without any of us being down there to say,
okay,
no, it's not really. You can come in, but quickly.
Yeah, no, but we're going to
there might be other people. We're going to go in a barrow, we'll pick up more people.
Can I suggest just you hang here till just after 12?
Okay.
Because that's when your shit's going to be.
Well, we were, if we saw anyone on the way, we were going to turn around and come straight back. If we saw the police coming up or anything, we were just going to turn around and come straight back.
Well, the police are on their way.
They are.
They've closed the forest. They're weighing it up for restricted zone, so that's inches off. Anybody that's not up at the top or locked on may possibly just get arrested after being told this is a really good zone that the police leave. And if you don't leave, they may grab you. Which is clearing their right.
Okay, what happens when the police...
We had a phone call from the cops this morning. They wanted me to get up here today.
Cops wanted you up here?
Yeah, they were a bit concerned about the situation. They thought if the, this tree thing could be resolved, then it might quieten down a bit.
V-notches between just here and the kilometre and a half down the road place where we were camped. There's also been koala scats found down the bottom there. I've just heard from Parks and Wildlife that they were informed by forestry yesterday, and Parks and Wildlife have allowed them to open an old road to get down into the bottom of the compartment. They're not allowed to go anywhere near where the koala scats were found or down in the Yellow Belly area. But we need you...
So they're allowed in back into that bottom compartment?
That's it.
So this is under one of their temporary licences?
Yeah.
One of the temporary licences?
Yeah.
The area that we know that the Yellow Bellies are in, according to them, didn't have V-notches because it was pretty lush vegetation and they could get food from other sources and they wouldn't necessarily need to do V-notches there. So that was how they sort of got out of it.
Which brings up the big question. If you've got V-notches, why do they have all these hell prescriptions? But if we've got recordings of the noises, why aren't the prescriptions valid? That's like one of the burning issues here with this Yellow Belly stuff.
Right. So the simple lack of nocturnal surveys for arboreal mammals and coming up in the day in winter on blowy days,
looking for nocturnal animals during the day, isn't that great? It makes heaps of sense. You work for the government. And you work from 9 to 5.
Well, from my experience with them, sometimes they're quite obvious that they're V-notches, and other times they're obvious if they're not.
Yeah.
And then there's an area of grey in between that you're not sure. So.
I got a couple of Yellow Bellies on video actually just up here as well, so I'll just show you the trees they were sitting in.
Well, what's the problem with if you've got all these positive IDs of Yellow Bellies, what are they?
Well, we went in with them. I didn't go in with them, but a few people went in yesterday with them, and they've been in before. Basically haven't found anything in the areas that we're looking.
So they're denying their existence.
Not just, but this is where I found the tubers anyway, just here.
And they went off the Barbara?
Yeah. There's quite a few little marks on it. Like, you can sort of see when you get up there too. But on that big bulge there.
Yeah,
right.
They've run someone over.
But it is a great sleeping platform, eh?
Well, I don't know. I don't think I'd want to sleep on it all night.
So this is Gabe's shack, eh?
Come on, Nicky, build it for Gabe's spirit.
out the back one?
They might reply half an hour or a few hours later, especially the powerfuls. But the sooties and the masts will generally reply pretty much within minutes. Well, the sooties especially pretty close. And then,
why do they wait so long, powerful?
What sort? There's a lot of power from the door.
And if you don't get the owls, then the yellow bellies might start up.
What sort of volume do you play it at?
As loud as you can, really. So, and what I think about it, packs it off to Sue Walker, recommending that there be more surveys done in the area and that they revise the prescriptions. We'll see what they, see what she does with it, but I think one page get off the day for it.
Fantastic.
It's certainly suitable habitat. Suitable habitat for a number of endangered species. Make a move.
Well, look, thanks very much for your time.
See you later.
And drop in any time, please.
Bye.
Everybody's got a bloody video today.
You should get some women placement up there too, eh?
Yeah. The authorisation. I'm not moving until I've seen a piece of paper that has a boundary on it and that has State Forests say that this area is now prohibited. I know that I'm well within my rights to say that. I need to see a piece of paper which says this forest is now closed with some boundaries. No, 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 it's got to be written out, typed.
Yeah, it is
typed. Type piece of paper.
This is my piece of paper. And it's got the boundaries marked with the area that it's closed. And you people, this is closed.
What's the story with national parks? Are they coming up tonight? We heard rumours that they were.
I have no idea what national parks are doing at this stage.
Right.
All I'm doing is suggesting you people, this is closed. We're asking you to leave, hopefully, at your own will.
Yeah. Is it agreed that you won't go into the area that's still being disputed about the yellow bellies and the koala scats? Because we've just had the expert here and he is highly recommending that national parks come out here and do a nocturnal study. Highly recommending.
Having no further discussion.
They're prohibited where we live.
That's wonderful.
They're prohibited where we live.
This is access to my house.
Ah, no!
Down this road.
You know what? This has got two issues here, and one of them, some of
them, that's prohibited the where we live.
And we've watched what happened to our rivers. Okay, why don't the people listen? I mean, how come we have to get all our land to get any?
Why do they keep doing
you can
this?
Do anything you bloody like.
That's not.
Not you, but the loggers.
Right. So, unfortunately, at this stage, the forest has been closed and we've got to ask you to move on.
Good on you. Good on you, State Forest. You never want to
see
anybody.
I saw the look on your face when you saw that greater site yesterday.
What a mob of wankers. I don't want to let anybody see what they're doing. So they've got to close fast hectares of forest. 600 cubic metres they want to take out of here.
But
so they've got to close. Okay. How big is it?
Right.
How big is it?
That's where it is.
That's.
That's humongous.
Cabbage Tree Creek, Kosakai Road, McKay's Road, the bottom of Little Wonder Creek. Oh man, that's like thousands of hectares.
That's my backyard.
Thousands of hectares. I'm allowed to walk over my backyard. 600 cubic meters. Bullshit, they want to lock 600 cubic
metres. So none of the residents are allowed to walk in their backyard virtually.
I canoe up and down with my kids up and down that river. I haven't swum in it for 3 fucking years. And from you people logging it, some jerk out there that doesn't have any trees on the property and who gets landslides that go into it. I know what you can do. You can grow polonia trees that take 8 years to grow and you won't do it.
They're only going to log that compartment, but they've prohibited several thousand hectares.
I could
Jeez, I'd like to have a job in state forest so I had the power to throw people out of where they live. Plants, animals, humans.
Fuck, I'd like to have a job with state forest.
Just everybody's access to everywhere.
There's a lot of locals living here as well. You've literally, you've got people here whose backyards are prohibited from.
My backyard's prohibited from me. There's my backyard just there.
So you're not allowed to walk over your back ridge virtually. No. Nobody's allowed to go out of their property. No one's allowed to use the forest.
Nobody.
Nobody. It's a $2,000 fine if you set foot over the edge.
No.
Yes.
Yep. You have
a
look.
That's what it says.
You have a look.
That's what it says.
Give you a warning, they say. You're in a river zone. If you don't leave, you'll be...
Yeah.
We've been given a warning.
But virtually.
We've been given the warning, right? That's the warning. Right. I now have nowhere to live.
Irrespective of this week's worth of vlogging, any more he will talk to us on, you're saying?
Yeah, he said he'll come back and engage me.
Chris, you're not allowed to
you
go over the backyard into the forest.
You guys stay there and hang in.
You're not allowed to go over the back, your backyard into the forest. They
They're
closed the forest.
It's
a $2,000 fine on you walking over your back boundary.
Without hacking a hell of a lot of trees down.
Hey? And I don't think you feel like getting arrested, Jared. It's my decision.
Yep.
Move that candle lever and
I
can't move.
Yeah, everything. What we'll do, right, you've been given the direction.
How long have we got?
Listen to me.
Hang on, let him go.
The direction is valid from this point onwards. We'll go back down there and give you a chance to talk amongst yourselves in peace.
What about our camp?
Mate,
what about our camp?
You're going to have to move.
Where to?
I don't know.
How?
I don't know.
How long have we got?
We'll be reasonable about it, but you're going to have to move.
How long have we got?
Well, as
can
soon
we come
as
back
possible.
Tomorrow?
No.
Well, when can we come back?
When the park's
when you
again.
Say reasonable.
Whose discretion's that after? To the loggers?
Yeah. We're not allowed off of our... You mean we're not allowed... I own 120 acres over here. I'm not allowed over my back boundary there.
No,
I'm not allowed over
you're not. Technically, no.
Technically,
no.
I don't agree with
home.
That.
That's
I'm sorry, but I don't
forest.
Agree with
it. It's common sense.
I understand that.
If you've got to go for whatever, do something that you normally do of a day or whatever, that's not the beef.
What about living?
Yeah,
what about living?
The beef is, that,
sure,
like I said,
that.
For control purposes,
yeah.
That whole area is
being
closed.
Yeah.
So if you do...
Do you even care?
Until when?
Of
course it doesn't.
Until they say,
so the forestry commissioner who's calling all the shots and you do what they tell you to do,
Can we get the forestry plan from the forest?
I mean, they don't even live here.
Can we?
Right, we're going to go, like I said, I'm not going to argue.
Okay.
I've given you a direction.
Sure. Steve Rayson's the one to ask these questions.
He's up the hill. He's up the hill in there now.
He said he'll come back and
discuss it.
The policeman said to us he will come back and tell us... And he'll discuss it with us.
Right, but I've given a direction. The direction is from this point onwards,
2 o'clock,
we'll give you time to have a talk amongst yourselves to decide what you want to do, but then we're going to have to forcibly remove anybody that is still here.
Shouldn't there be a consultation with Steve Rayson before this happens?
Nah.
It's, why not? Between...
I've just given them the demand, that's
the forestry,
it. I don't want to get into any arguments.
The forestry have told the police what to do. The police are doing what they're told by the forestry.
No, the forestry is virtually their
so
boss
the forestry
now.
Is the boss of all of this, not the police,
forestry
not anybody. The forestry do what they're told by the government. And we voted them in. Well, not me personally, but...
Not me.
Not me.
I particularly don't feel like getting arrested right now. Okay? I don't know what that, I think... Steve Rayson.
Well, what are they going to do? They're just going to get us down and...
Well, it'll take...
I'll arrest you and then tow the cars. That's what I said. I'll arrest you and the cars will be towed.
They can't tow the cars out yet.
I've never been arrested and I don't intend
to be. I'll drive the cars.
The whole thing's designed.
See, what you do, you just hold it off until you get the chariot upright, and then you drop down and put your neck just above the axle and push through that.
Destroy our land, you buggers. Go on.
Yeah, how do you guys sleep at night? How do you guys bloody sleep?
And your kids, kids! Sweet fuck all! A fucking beer gut!
The others are often arrested where?
Under the bulldozers.
But they haven't been brought through yet.
No.
Have they been cut off? Presumably.
They're off. They're arrested. That's why these places are going to start work. Yeah. So. Yeah.
It's got to happen. Somebody's got to be in this pod.
I sit down and pretend they're talking to us, Steve Rayfield, and he'll tell us anything we want to hear, but whether it happens or not, you know. I mean, I live on the other side of that hill. I live here, I see all these animals, I see the river going like this every year with less and less water. With no water, we can't live out there. I have to leave my property. It's not worth what I pay for it, man.
Being shot past us, right? Yeah, I want to talk. We want to talk to Steve.
Please, can we just talk
back
to him?
In his office.
No.
Or at another location, not here.
Why? Didn't you pass on our message that we wanted to talk to him here? Why did he walk straight past us?
I don't know. You'll have to ask him.
He said,
right, "If you don't go, this is the last warning. Unfortunately, we're going to have to start."
Where's Steve? I want to talk to Steve.
Come on, let's go. Come on.
No, Jerry, you come with me. I'll take you home.
Yeah, he has been living up here for a bit.
We'll just stand out of the way.
Sorry, that was part of the negotiations this morning. Of course, you didn't agree to it. It said, hold you as well.
I'm afraid
what
I'm
I suggest
not
you do
to be arrested.
Is
go in and
see Steve Grayson and start talking to him again.
I'm going to Yeranga now.
You're going to have to talk to him, but unfortunately, but not here.
See, we've just heard the yellow-bellied glider expert mistake here. He's just given us a tape to play tonight to prove that the stuff's in there.
I know,
it's a piece of atrocious crime. I know, I'm just letting you know what's happening here and why people are feeling so strongly about all this.
That's fair enough.
This is really stuff.
Like I said, I can't buy into that, right? I've got to stay neutral.
Fair enough.
And I don't want to go coming in and rough handling everybody. I'd rather see you go out. Go and see him and put that to him. You've got, like I said, you won a heap of brownie points there yesterday by negotiation, by doing it the right way. Keep doing that. Okay?
Okay, no.
Rightio. Righty-o, everybody else going to have to start moving along, sorry. That's the way
it is. Can we have one person here just to keep an eye on our friends and make sure everything's alright?
Nah, everybody goes.
That's why they're going to be arrested.
Uh-huh. It's just, you know, there's no female police here or anything either, so like...
Hey, we can't help
that. That's right.
Just the way it is. Doesn't matter. You're going to have to move along.
No, you don't want police liaison for their safety or anything like that.
Sorry?
The police liaison for their safety.
Emergency police rescue or anything else?
We're going to have to organise that. If something happens to them, that's our responsibility.
But you're not going to just try and pull them down without police rescue coming in to have a look or something like that, are you? Because this is dangerous, you know?
Like, mate, I'm not commenting on that. But
in other words, just go and they'll do it.
Come on. Everybody, start moving along, otherwise you're going to have no option but to start arresting.
If you roll him down, you won't get a lower him down.
You're going to do nothing stupid. Rightio.
Hang in,
guys. They won't come.
We'd prefer to leave someone here to keep an eye on them, you know, from our side as well, but that's not possible.
As you know, they're trespassers, so.
We're concerned for their safety.
Take care.
How come I'm not allowed to stay here?
Sorry.
Legally, we've got to get out.
I've asked you nicely.
Yeah,
you
I know.
Okay. Kick ass, don't take no shit. When can we have a talk with you?
Is it going to be the same as the last one?
The policeman told us if we left peaceably, we'd be able to have a talk with you.
When all obstacles are removed.
That's got nothing to do with me.
It has to do with me. When all obstacles are removed and we leave the closed area, then I'm prepared to talk to people.
I
am also prepared to discuss with one or two people on site in my company what's going on.
I'm here as part of the Buckrup Indian Water Users Group. I'm not here as part of the forest dwellers or whatever. I'm asking you when... So
shouldn't the residents have a say in it, the people that own the land that you've virtually just stop them from walking in their backyards? It's all banned now. But you don't want to talk
Steve,
to
Steve, you haven't given me an answer yet.
You came
Steve
to talk to us and you had it all written down, but you wouldn't let us have a say.
I think Steve's so bloody ashamed of himself, he can't get any words out.
Can you sleep at night either, Steve?
No.
Look at all these cameras.
Now I haven't been on so much bloody video since I was in the movies.
Yes, there's a police station.
No, not a police station.
But outside the prohibited area. Yeah.
Outside the area. Yeah, it's
a prohibited area.
No worries.
Which point would I be delivered at?
We just said we're not going
to. But they're not under
arrest. It'll be outside the.
I want to talk about.
But they're not under arrest at this point.
I've got something totally different. I'm
just wondering about you.
They're not going to be charged.
I don't know if they're going to be dumped out in the middle of nowhere.
Steve, you haven't given me an answer yet.
Unfortunately, he's not prepared to talk at this stage.
I'm quite within my rights to ask him to give me a time. It's all I want.
Well, you're going to have to make an appointment with him another time.
Well, I don't want to leave here until he makes an appointment with me for another time. What more rights has he got than me as a human being in this forest? This is what it all boils down to, you know? None of us, even you guys, haven't got any choice. You've got no choice, we've got no choice. It just doesn't make sense.
Hey, we're going to try pulling it down.
Help! Help! Help!
Want everybody to dust first now.
Help!
Don't pull it down, you'll kill them.
Help! Help!
gentlemen. Yeah. Who's got my car key? Steve, can I talk to you, please?
No, no, not at the moment. I have something to say.
I am Stephen David Rayson. I'm the district forester. I am an authorised officer under the Forestry Act. I am authorised to close this forest. I have closed the forest and have directed that signs be erected to this effect. You are now required to leave as you are in breach of the forestry of the regulations under the Forestry Act.
Okay. Right, are you leaving now or are you going to be arrested?
Can I
get someone to
Are you leaving now or are you going to be arrested? But hold the back door.
Someone man hurt up. I can hear him screaming.
He's going
to talk to me Friday.
Everybody move along. Otherwise, you'll be arrested. The area which you have been staying is within the closed area. You are required to leave there.
Didn't change after the war, did it? Your parents disciplined you too much, but you kept it up. It doesn't work in this community anymore.
Come on.
We were so surprised to see a dozer in there the day before yesterday. We had no time to do anything else but to put tripods up and sit on them so that we could hold them up for just long enough to say, right, let's go and have a look at this together. Let's have
we
a
just
look.
Want to check the marking foreman's work.
We so can't now. No, we can't. We can't. We've been prohibited from there. No.
He said it was very unusual that Yellow Belly's V-notches weren't found.
There's a colony of YBGs in there. We
he
hear
says
them.
It's unusual that we,
I mean, we live
see
down
them.
We're also a bit worried that they might try and pull those people off those constructions without knowing what they're doing.
Safety first.
Okay. The loggers are the ones.
Safety first.
No, but if,
we don't want
it'd be much appreciated if you make sure that somebody's kept an eye on them there, even if
that's
they're staying
there. Right now. So we'll go and do that, and we'll come back and see you.
All right.
Okay?
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks,
bye.
Inspector.
For 600 cubes, they brought in a busload of police, a caravan,
going on?
A cherry
picker. Go and get your caravan.
That's a portable charge room. So what are you doing here?
Closing the forest.
So what's it mean to close the forest?
Nobody can go in without state forest approval. It's all self-explanatory there.
Yay!
We're really pissed off with this, and the reason that we put the tripods up was because they started logging A without telling us and B without finalising anything. It was all left hanging up in the air.
Because they know that if everything's finalised, then they're not going to be allowed in there. Because if they do all the EISs and everything, and that guy gets further studies done on the yellow belly gliders and stuff like that, they're not going to be able to go in there. That's why they're there now, isn't it? Because if they go through all the legal recourse that they have to, they're not going to have a leg to stand on. They've just wasted so much money, more than the trees are worth in the first place.
Yeah.
How many police do you think they had there?
At least 20.
You know, it's funny, like, just like the police were
coming up at the start of it with just the one guy saying, oh, look, we're the mediator, we're neutral, you know, we've got to try and negotiate between the two. After lunch, they all come in wearing the same coloured jackets that are glowing like, you know, knights of the fluoro plastic. And start talking to... The police are talking to, you know, my friends and saying, look, we've got to do this, we've got to do this. The forestry and the police sort of became this one thing.
They always
all
do.
All of a sudden.
They always do.
You know? And so it's pretty obvious that they're all just pawns for someone else.
Oh, yeah. Forestry, I mean, the cops are happy because they're being paid
for $200 a day
by
to walk around in the pretty forest.
By state forest.
Isn't it uncanny that the moment the blockade, goes public, the moment it goes public, then we get these low-flying fucking
F-111s
and
blockade F-18. I've been to, there's been training run because we're the closest thing that Australia has to terrorists. And these guys have got to practice on something.
Right, so they practice on blockades.
They've got their... That plane had all its sensors on full bore.
They get to find people sitting around campsites and campfires under canopy in the forest. You know, that's exactly the sort of guerrilla training that the Australian Army and Intelligence needs.
Yeah.
And look, every time we've been to a blockade, the day it goes public, like, okay, the tripods are up today, that's the day it comes over.
Right.
Doesn't come over before, doesn't come over after, it comes over when you put out that press release.
Right, when the terrorists are in view. Terrorist practice.
They're actually overgrown little boys that used to play.
Of course they are.
Guns
and
Tonka toys.
Skirmish with
Tonka toys, I mean, fuck me dead.
You think he'll let you stay in here? I mean, they've closed the forest. It's not his choice, really. It's Steve Raisin's choice, right? It's not the cop's choice.
Well, if they want to come and get us out because we're staying here...
I'll use the old fire hazard trick on you, though, won't they?
We've got a knapsack. We've got all the requirements. He wants 200 litres of water.
Yeah, but they've closed the forest, right? Full stop. They've just closed the forest. They don't need to talk about fire restrictions or anything else. He's got the power to close the forest. It's there. Only Steve Raisin and the army can close areas of land in Australia.
Basic foresters.
What is their reason, though, behind it?
Protect the public is the actual reason for the legislation.
Public,
yeah.
To protect the public.
Right. And is that the fire thing or logging?
Dangerous.
Dangerous.
Trees might fall on you. Right. So we've got to close the forest so trees don't fall on you. Right?
Yay! That's okay! Fucking, I wasn't going to come down and then he fucking said, right, if you don't come down, we'll go back to the first harvest plan.
They gave up. You know, they all gave up.
They gave up. They thought it was a fucking amazing contraption.
They gave up.
Did they? Yeah, they gave up.
I got them all. I said, I'm not coming down. I'm not coming down until all you say you're fucked and you admit defeat because, you know, I like chess and you've got to be good chess players. And
oh, beautiful.
Oh,
and they did it. And it, like the first
what,
dude...
They admitted it?
Yeah.
Did they bring the cherry picker up?
Yep.
And it didn't work.
And it didn't work.
Yes!
Set.
I said to him, I said, okay, I'm coming down.
Did you have the key?
Hey, nah, but I did it in such a way that it was tied, really tight around this foot, and then I slipped my other foot under it, and it made it all tighter.
Right, so you could slip that foot out.
Yeah, but they didn't know that, and it was like this.
Right.
And locked there really tight, and I said, oh, okay, I'm coming down, right? And they were up there with the cherry picker doing the whole trip, and they've fucking got the grader there with chains and the chainsaw and people everywhere.
So the...
And then I just went, oh, that's right, I'm chained here, I can't give up. And like they put the cherry picker back down and got out, and they're going, oh, he's coming down, good on you, and I went, oh, no, I can't, sorry. I forgot. Oh, how silly of me.
They'll bring the cherry picker in and whenever they go, like, the slightest centimetre near it, and go, I'm going, you fucking dead! Don't you come near this log! Oh, I was just fucking, you know how I was going off the wall. Help, help, screaming at them like that.
Oh, man, we thought, we thought you were having your leg locked off.
Yeah,
it seriously sounded like you were having your leg locked off.
I know. I know, but it's that good footage.
Hey, there's a police officer coming down here.
There's a few.
Now? They're going to negotiate things with us, like, get out.
No.
Now?
What, Steve's coming with them?
I don't know.
Lots of policemen. Yeah. I got really cheeky with him that, and I said, look, okay, all you guys, I don't mean to be a smart ass, but I'm really excited. It's the first time you've done it, it's the first time I've done it, you know. We're going to get it wrong, okay, and someone's going to get hurt, and it's going to be me.
So, like... Who's this such a Bowfield cop?
And they're all there going,
come on, just come in.
Tell your friend to come down, you're endangering them. And then they tell me, tell the girl to come in, because you're endangering her. And I said, looks like we're... Each other.
And we can't tell each other what to do because
we're individuals. Yes. Yeah, serious.
Sergeant Farrellville gave us a lift. Yeah, but he reckoned we'd done a fucking excellent job, hey.
He said you made your point, you did a wicked job. They were baffled, you know. Just done.
So they couldn't do it. They couldn't get it down.
They couldn't do it. There's just no way. So they brought the chainsaw out. Though. You know, oh, they would have got it down, but they started. Oh, maybe not. They started the chainsaw on the first tripod.
Yeah.
And started sawing the leg down.
I didn't trust them.
Turn chainsaw off because you're going to hurt us. You know, and Marty started screaming and yelling and the chainsaw.
Yeah, he started the chainsaw. I'm gone. Don't you dare and fucking God, don't you dare! And he stopped.
I said that they were putting 20 people out of the home, so you could say, you know, 10.
At least 10 people wandering the forest.
Yeah.
Oh,
we've
got...
Hey, check this out. Forestry have kindly provided us with really nice waterproof mats for our area.
Is this where we're not allowed?
What happened to Ren and...
It'll take us another hour or two. We're not sure about your safety, but when we get you down, we're not going to arrest you.
So they don't want any arrests, that's all more paperwork. Yeah.
Political.
The whole thing political
because
exercise.
They know that we can't get as much media if we've had no arrests.
I'm thinking about driving out, but I'm not going to be able to. That's it. We're not allowed back in.
You got it, that's the one.
They'll stop us.
Yeah. I'm not going to be able to drive back up here. I think you're going to have to decide whether you're going to make this the camp or pull out. And if you're going to make this the camp, you've got to work out how to supply this through that much closed forest. So this is not a very viable place for one right now.
No, you're better off going down there.
But they'll just come in and trash it, huh?
Oh, man, I've got to have a fucking good night's sleep before I do Black Wallaby.
But it's quite possible to get up into a private block that they can't find the owner of, that's surrounded by forest on all sides, right?
Can we get into it?
Yeah, we can get into it.
You're meant to be on the roads in a closed forest.
Well, I mean, it's only 200 metres by road into that private
road. It's only about 200 metres of actual road that's in the enclosed area. The rest of it's all not enclosed area. And they can't, as you can see on that map, private block's not included. You can see by the boundary, that's not included in the exclusion zone. It's even said that. Look there, it says closure area boundary shown thus. So that's all the way around there. The Springs Road, up the Springs Road, up to the Crossacre and just up the Chute Road. It's just a quick blip. It's like that, but it's only about a...
They haven't closed that is forest closed, prohibited.
Yeah. So you've got to enforce that. Nobody can go in. Anybody at all. Forest can go into a job, 4 weeks. Out again.
Destroy my water supply.
Anyway, you can take that issue up with, you know,
we've been trying to do that.
They have actually been trying.
And this is how, you know, that's what it came to. Like, it came down to that because we're not being heard, listen, you know. That's what it came down to.
Are you all clear on that?
Yeah.
Okay,
no worries.
We can't be any fairer to you.
No, okay. No. I don't understand your situation.
All the best.
Thank you.
Catch
you.
Bye.
Thanks, man.
Say no more.
Oh, that's not fucking fair. They got driven back to camp and we got
dropped off here. Yeah, just goes to show you should have walked along the tripod.
The place is like 6,000 hectares of land.
600
So they can't go back on their logging agreements. They can go back on the ones they made with you blokes, but they can't go back on the ones with the water users
and
groups.
And that was on top of ours. So
that's right. That's the minimum we're going to accept is everything that's in yours and in ours.
And here it is, Buckrabindini Creek. Lower Little Wonder.
It's not about
the Amazing how it used to be 5,000 species an acre, isn't it?
Out in the Ayan forest.
See? I think, huh? That big gap. That's definitely a change.
Oh, yeah.
There's no way that they can say that's not a change.
That old black that's been cut into living wood. It wasn't cut by the forestry workers. The wood's grown after it was cut.
No.
See?
No, you can see how it's grown over the edges here.
Yeah, see?
Around it all. Yeah, and they've grown out.
Beautiful.
He's cut right in there. I struggle with something like this. He's cut right in there. Hey, he's cut right in there with one of these.
Alright.
Right around, he's cut it.
Bone axe.
Hey. He's ripped that right in. And I thought this would be main walking track, see?
Yeah, they reckon they used to mark every so far up to the park to mark them.
Yeah, on the main track too.
Enormous, they're old, you know, 300 year old logs.
Just, and they're overloaded with just three logs on, you know. They're monsters.
That's probably one tree cut into three.
And when people see, you know, people dancing around on blockades and things like that, the first thing they think of is, what are they on? Where they get the money for
benefits.
It, you know, and like they're very, very critical, and
it's our job.
And it's almost like you're behind the eight ball straight away. Like, I think the visual is very, very important aspect to look at. It's a serious issue, and I really think it should be dealt with seriously.
That's why we need more like families up there too.
Yeah. You know, because we're the ones that are willing to do it. That's
why. It seems a pity that you do all this really good work, and a visual comes up, and such a big percentage of people just put this really bigoted thing up, and you've lost them.
The other thing is, no matter how we dress, we're behind that eight ball. No matter how we dress, we start out behind that eight ball anyway.
Ingrid's had a hand up for a while, and then Tim.
I was just going to say on this, we have been trying to get people that have got jobs and people like that up there the whole time. We've been trying, we've been having open day. No one turned up, you know, that we didn't know, you know, and we're happy to have people like that up. But it's a matter of getting them to come up and help. That's the matter here.
Another matter is,
Laura?
The problem with that is tomorrow, I think you're going to get a lot of people coming tomorrow, but they're working people, some of them. They won't be able to come on Monday.
On Tuesday this week, 25 police broke up a blockade of the Little Wonder Forest in the upper Buckrabindini water catchment west of Barrabin. The Buckrabindini Valley, an arm of the Nambucca River, is an example of what State Forest is doing to all New South Wales coastal rivers. The forest of the Little Wonder catchment is the only forest producing any surface water flow for the whole of the Buckra Valley. The North East Forest Alliance calls upon all supporters to join in a forest occupation to defend our access to our forest, to defend remaining high conservation value old growth forest, habitat of endangered species, precious water-producing forest, and to support the native title claim over this forest by the Gumbenga Nation. The English Queen's New South Wales government has no legitimate power over these forests. We already have around 40 people and need to overwhelm the English Queen's forces and put the old-growth forest, water catchment, endangered species issue back in the media and force this dumb, stupid, gutless, irresponsible New South Wales colonial government out of our remnant old-growth forest.
Tree, as well as the staircase, all from, I didn't know that till I read the little plaque on the wall.
Made from one of these, eh?
They glorify it, don't they?
Oh yeah,
glorify
they figure they had lots then and they could do what they like.
Red cedar.
And they used
to
put them on boats in Bowerville and sail them out.
Yeah.
You couldn't float a bloody...
You can't get a kayak down there.
They used to actually put trees like this would be a twig compared to some of the big bugs they used to have.
Yeah.
That's it. You rub that on, that'll cure the stinger. Do they grow next to one another as well? This is probably one of the biggest trees you'll ever see anywhere of any kind.
Fig. It's hollow and
you look in and you get a big
it's about
big.
6 foot in diameter in the on the inside. When you go up, take your shoes off.
Hello, Sky. I can see you down there. bird's nest view up here for sure.
How high do you reckon we are?
Well, we've just been discussing it. It's pretty hard to focus on the ground, looking at 40 metres up. Where we are, and there's probably, you know, another, I don't know, 20 to go up there.
There's a very nice window in the top of this giant strangler peak.
Runs and cuts. By the time they chuck away the discard there, they might be about, oh, I'd say maybe a third or a quarter of the stump would be of the whole tree proper would be usable.
Probably a quarter, I reckon.
And they call that 120 what? Foot long? Cubic meters? Couldn't be right. Not much of a tree, is it? Well, it looks like that. I mean, it's been a beautiful big guy standing up, eh? By the time they've taken the pieces they call rubbish off, they're wasting more than three quarters of the tree. Considering what's underground, they're probably only taking away about an eighth. That's outrageous, isn't it? And then the waste that arrives at the mill is just unbelievable. You know, you can see what's laying around here from years gone by. There's pieces laying everywhere they don't even bother to take out. And look at the size of some of these babies. Yeah, that's it. Oh, that's a bit of firewood for someone. Yeah, that's some of these babies.
This would have to be one of the biggest fern trees you're going to see, you know, like this century, this decade. Look at it.
Can't be a very sensitive area then, can it? To be logging right inside of here.
It doesn't look good as far as erosion goes on that gully. It will most certainly wash down into that gully.
And this is the spot where the koala scats were found, which stopped the bulldozer proceeding just before the forest was closed. And as you can see, the bulldozers definitely proceeded through what was obviously koala habitat and yellow-bellied glider habitat. And this is a stump of a tallowwood tree right in the koala habitat. A tallowwood tree is one of the major feed trees for koalas. Looks like they only took about 20 foot out of this tree and left the rest, eh?
Yeah. The old scraps lying over there.
By fire catterns and platycerium super bums so that we can relocate them into unendangered forest. Our own sanctuary of 500 acres that'll never be logged. Thank you. the staghorn is the super bum, superbum. And by far catum is the elkhorn.
And what, these are just lying around dead trees, yeah?
They're the heads of dead trees that have been cut down previously. They're laying around the logging dump here.
What'll happen to them if they're left there, do you reckon?
Oh, they'll just rot on the ground and become dirt. They'll be totally dead, eaten by insects and whatever else comes along and destroys them. Otherwise, they just die and be burnt to death by the sun. Of course, a bulldozer could run over them tomorrow and they won't be there for even the insects to eat.
And some rather big breaks in the forest canopy.
This whole section of Little Wonder is really out of sight of the tourist drives.
It's hard just standing here, it's too steep.
Do you see any habitat trees around here at all? Any trees marked with an H anywhere? Any trees capable of supporting any animal life anywhere? And yet this area is easily bigger than a couple of hectares that we're looking at. There's not one habitat tree anywhere in here.
I mean, I don't know how it's going to repair itself from a mess like this.
Give it a couple of thousand years, you never know.
And no more logging.
Life goes on here in Little Wonder.
Family of lizards.
There's my home.
Down through there. Someone's house I can see down there. Is that yours?
Could be. Here it is, the end of the forest. The end of the world.
Assurances on the phone. Can you give us a written assurance that only 600
cubes? I don't see the relevance of the volume. It's what we do with the bush that is relevant, surely.
Well, I mean, the more trees you take out, the more damage it does.
So you must reduce the
volume. Why is so much forest closed then?
Because the,
why
6,000 hectares closed over 50 hectares of logging? It's an entirely separate problem.
Just
And I don't propose to go into all that sort of detail. As I said, in this situation, it's not a fair situation in which to discuss.
It's not a fair situation to discuss a lot of things, but a lot of locals are wondering why log trucks are coming out at night, for instance, out of that area. People are hearing them and seeing them coming out at night. And I think that you should be aware of this as a forester in the area. You should be aware of this. And if you're not aware of it, there's a big problem. The locals are watching trucks coming out both ways from that compartment at night. Now, can you explain to us why that's happening?
What's wrong with the log truck coming out?
Middle of the night at 3 a.m.
I don't believe it, but what's wrong with it?
Well, you don't have any control over what they're taking out at that stage, do you?
Yes, we do.
Do you?
You have foremen up there at midnight, do you? Checking that rainforest timbers worth $10,000 or more aren't being taken out.
The rainforest timbers leave stumps and, you know, we'd see them. I mean, it's just not on any of that sort of stuff. We're not cutting rainforest.
There's a sneak train cut
into the rainforest there right now, there, but no one's allowed to look at it. It's not
people
right.
are going in every night and looking at it.
Yeah, that's the point. The forest is closed.
Okay, what's happened?
There's a sneak track going right through the middle of rainforest. How could this occur? I'd really like to know. You know, and I'm sure you're not going to be able to tell me. I'm sure maybe the district forester
won't
be able to tell me.
A sneak track going right through rainforest.
We also don't understand why, you know, like, you're logging in 100 compartments in this management area. Now, we're not arguing with you over most of those compartments, and out of the 100-odd compartments that you're logging in this area, we're only really arguing with you about three of them. Now, why is it that nobody really listens to what it is we're saying when we're only arguing about 3% of the area that's about to be logged in?
Everybody,
get
out. They're coming.
No, we asked you to give us a harvest plan. You said you had one inside. Do you have a harvest plan? So the Forestry Commission doesn't have a copy of the harvest plan.
Well, sure we do.
This is the Forestry Commission building. You don't have a copy of the harvest plan up there, and you're telling us it exists, and we've looked at the ones up there that the contractors are using, and there is no new harvest plan, and you're lying to us, Dale. Why is this going on?
You're not putting me in a fair situation. If you come in one at a time, I'll talk
to you. No, our water supply and our children's water supply depends on this. We're not putting you in a fair situation, Mr. Dale, living here in Noorunga on town water. Have a wonderful life.
State first, rape, pillage and plunder.
We can't be in the forest because it's a prohibited area, $2,000 fines and all that. So we've come here where it's not a prohibited area.
Over what?
Over the logging of Little Wonder.
Little Wonder that takes.
And the fact that they've closed the forest to us so that we can't see what they're doing. I mean, if what they were doing was okay, they wouldn't have prohibited the forest.
So your problem is closing off the forest?
One of our problems is closing off the forest. One of them is the fact that they haven't done adequate wildlife surveys. Another is they haven't done any negotiations with the Kuris, the local Aboriginal tribe, the Kumbungir. They haven't produced scientific evidence that says that the logging is not going to kill Little Wonder Creek. This much topsoil is going to end up in the river. That's why these guys.
Fluvial geomorphologists have done reports on similar, the same soil type, the hanging rock escarpment. It's all the same, only about 2 kilometres away, and they said logging should not take place over 25 degrees.
Well, that they're acting in breach of an agreement, or they're acting illegally, or what?
No, we haven't said that they're acting illegally because
so
if we.
So you're acting in breach of a gentleman's agreement, put it that way. Is that what they're doing?
Signed bits of paper.
And as far as water users are concerned, they've done no studies on the effects on the water supply.
I went up there last weekend. I usually go up almost
each weekend with my family. There's beautiful areas of forest that we go picnicking. I was accosted by the security guards up there who informed me they had a baseball bat and a shotgun. And they said to me, I had a witness with me, and I've put this down in a stat deck, that they have been given open hand by the police to use those weapons whichever that way they feel fit.
Mate,
I was,
disregard
it was
that.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to say it to you, is what good's it going to do?
They can't get up into the forest. The media can't get up into the forest now.
You had enough publicity.
Well, it depends if it's going to stop the logging. Yeah, probably for this morning. We've got our word. We've got our message out to the general
public.
How about
you break it up and move off, eh?
Well, that's for the rest of the group to decide.
Well, a lot of things have happened in the last 2 weeks. We haven't been filming much of it. Well, you haven't been filming much of it because, well, we've been running low on tape. Wow, like the police have come around and arrested our video cameraman with 9 charges. It looks like none of them are going to stick. We've also had a visit from the local contractors who've been logging in the Little Wonder, and they wanted to know where their chainsaw was because someone had ripped it off on a motorbike before their very eyes. But they came down and decided to find it for themselves and were threatening and looking for their chainsaw. We were sort of a little bit outnumbered, as it turned out, in the long run. So they left us. And what's more, Borrell Mill has been burnt down here in beautiful Barrowville.
Resolution to the Little Wonder campaign. It looks like forestry's pulled out. They managed to get 10 truckloads of timber out, and then they had to give up on closing the forest. Well, it's spring here in Upper Buckra Bendini, and there's still a few more compartments they want to log. There's a large bunch of people living here now, a large bunch of people who all want to stop the logging and who are all prepared to. So I think everything's going pretty well, really. Beautiful sunset, and I think we're going to get them. We just need a bit more help from our friends.
The protest is angry over the impact of logging in the Oak State Forest near Barrowville.
This latest standoff follows recent clashes between police and protesters who say there's not been sufficient consultation between forestry and green groups over the logging of Compartment 375. They're angry at the fact logging has started before an environmental impact statement is completed. State forests want to log 20 hectares of the 287-hectare compartment.
The compartment that we're logging is all regrowth forest. It's been logged twice before, once in the 60s and once in 1989, and we're not logging any old growth at all.
Following recent protests and damage caused to a grader, the department closed the forest to the public.
It's not a course of action that we like to take, but in this instance, the conservationists were running around in the operation and making a danger of themselves, getting in under felled trees, and we were left with no option but to close the forest for their safety.
But landowners and action groups claim logging will impact severely on one of the catchment's remaining sources of drinking water, despite forestry's claim of minimal risk.
How many times have forestry said that before? And Killer Cranky, which is only a few kilometres away from where they are, they logged that a few years back, and the EPA have just taken them to the cleaners for it, for gross negligence.
Green groups say they've uncovered evidence of 10 rare and endangered species near the logging site and rainforest near the disputed area.
The only snig track or logging road that they've pushed into the forest at the moment is over 27 degrees, heading straight for Little Wonder Creek. there's going to be a hell of a lot of soil that moves into Little Wonder Creek the very next time it rains.
The situation became heated after one protester scaled the forestry building. Police were then called in.
Well, the locals are watching trucks coming out both ways from their compartment at night. Now, can you explain to us why that's happening?
Eventually, they were forced to remove their banners, but with little consensus achieved today, it appears the standoff will continue for some time yet. Frank Bonacorso, 10 News.
Coming up, more damning evidence in the O.J. Simpson murder case and a showdown on the high sea.
Camp, Horseshoe Road, Horseshoe Road.
Oaks Forest.
Day two.
Well, day continuing two. On our surveys of 399. Yesterday, we discovered where the loggers have been. They were halfway through the operation in this compartment last year in November. They had to stop because the rain came. But the first place they targeted was the yellow-belly glider habitat. And from what we can tell, where they look like they're going next is another area of yellow-belly glider habitat. You walk out of that, today we did, and you sort of come out of the yellow-belly glider habitat, and then you hit all this rainforest. It's a really nice walk. We went this walk down to all this gorge. Back up a ridge, and there's koalas as well, so wherever you go, like, it's a beautiful place with what's happening in there.
Richie Havens
doing
artist.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child.
Oh.
I reckon you're working on a documentary, though, actually.
Yeah, but it makes good news footage, man. I don't think this is news footage. You wouldn't want to be seen doing this.
No, you've got footage of me maliciously damaging the road now.
Exactly.
And destroying vegetation on the...
Who was I playing for?
Fellow with fucking microphone.
Could you turn that off?
Well, I can't interview you, can I?
No. Interview me, mate.
How about the back of your head? Tell me, what happened?
No.
Put that fucking thing down, will you? I'm going to take those real quick.
You were asked to turn that camera off.
If you're filming me then,
I'd prefer if you ask permission before you do.